We talked about this yesterday, but we have something for everyone in the night sky tonight. Joining us this morning is Nick Bradley. He's the owner of Stargazers of Hawaii. Good morning, Nick. Thanks for coming back.
Thanks for having me.
You remember, Nick, he brought the big giant telescope in here, so he knows what he's doing. So I usually talk about the space events, but I want the expert to talk about these things. What can we see in the sky tonight?
Well, tonight, if you go out about an hour after sunset when it gets really dark, you'll see Saturn in the east, and the moon falls right behind. The Milky Way is also visible right now. In the west, you're going to see the Hokulea star setting and also the Big Dipper. Yeah, a lot of cool stuff.
So let me ask you this. Why is it called a blue moon?
Yes, blue moon is just a kind of a nickname for it. And so it means the second full moon in a calendar month. So it has nothing to do with changing color. Correct.
But it does have to do with the color if it's the blood red moon, because you get a haze on there, right?
Correct. That's for a lunar eclipse, and the moon turns red.
Yes. Yeah, they got all these names, and it seems to me I've been doing this for like 25, 30 years, and they keep adding names to these moons. But it's fun. It's really fun stuff. You got the blue moon tonight, and you got Saturn that you can see, right?
Correct. Yes.
So where are we going to look to see these things?
So you want to be looking in the east. And so east is where sunrise is. And so, Saturn looks like a little tiny star in the sky. You need a telescope to see the rings, but it's super cool.
Yeah, it is, definitely. So what time of night? Is it once it gets dark or in the morning before the sun comes up?
Yeah, in this time of year, right now, once it gets dark, about an hour after sunset, just look for the little bright star. There's no other bright stars near it, so it stands out. And you'll see it until January.
So I would say the best thing as far as seeing this, the most important thing is to get away from the light pollution in the city, correct?
Correct. But even if you are in the city, you can still see it. I like to say you can see the moon and the planets from the middle of New York City.
So, will the moon brightness take away from Saturn?
Actually, no. I've taken a picture of Saturn when the moon is right next to it. It doesn't diminish it at all. The stars are a different story.
Stars are a different story. So what is coming up, like in the future here? We just had the Perseid meteors. You saw that? How was that?
Yes, we saw about 70 meteor showers over about a three-hour period. A lot of fireballs, really cool. The next meteor shower is December 13th for the Gemini meteor shower. And also Jupiter starts coming back in November. And all the winter constellations start coming back. Orion, the Makalii, the Pleiades.
So there's a lot coming up, and when we get these big events, I'd like to bring you back here to talk about them, how we can do it. Now, you are the owner of Stargazers of Hawaii. You're going to be out tonight having a meeting, right?
Yes, we were doing a public stargazing show at the Prince Waikiki Hotel on their fifth floor pool deck. Really dark sky.
Oh.
Yes. And we'll be able to see Saturn, the Milky Way, some star clusters. Really cool.
So if people want to come by and take a look through the, is it where you have the big telescope there?
Exactly. Yes. That guy goes all over the place with me. Yes.
Excellent. I'm going to have to come out there and join you guys. Nick, thank you very much. We really appreciate it, because I know people love this stuff. It's very fun, especially the moons and super moons. It gets brighter too sometimes, right?
Just a little bit. Just because the moon is a little closer in its orbit during the full moon.
Yeah.
So it's about 15% brighter.
Especially on the horizon, it looks gigantic.
Exactly.
Right? Thank you. Appreciate it.